This is the brand new Bambu Lab P2S AMS combo. It's the second generation of the P series printers. It has several improvements over the previous P1S, and we're getting into it now. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. So, Bambu Lab sent over the new P2S AMS combo, and well, this is it. First, I want to talk about its specs and features and how it improves on the previous generation. Then we'll see a few prints, and finally I'll let you know what I think about it. One of the first things you'll notice is that the P2S now has a 5-inch color touchscreen with an adjustable tilt angle instead of the P1S's non-adjustable monochrome dot matrix screen with the navigation buttons. I'm not saying the P1S was hard to use, it just took a little bit of getting used to. The touchscreen makes it so much faster to work with the printer when you're standing in front of it. It's running Bambu Lab's second generation user interface, so it matches what's on the X1 and H2 series printers. The printer's internal lighting is just so much brighter on the P2S than it is on the P1S, so it's super easy to see what's going on inside the machine. And while you're looking around in there, you'll see the same 256x256x256mm build volume that Bambu Lab started with on the X1 series and carried into the P1 series and the A1. It's a build volume that sort of defines a mid-size 3D printer these days. The bed still has a spring steel flex plate with a textured PEI coating, but on the P2S, the bed could get to 110 degrees Celsius, instead of the P1's 100 degrees. There are some nice changes to the tool head as well. The P2S has the H2 series' DynaSense extruder, which uses an eddy current sensor to measure nozzle pressure, and it uses these measurements to adjust flow rate for better prints. The nozzle on the P2S goes to 300 degrees Celsius just like on the P1 series, but now the P2S uses the same nozzles as the H2 series. So not only do you get access to nozzles designed for the H2 printers, you also get the H2's easy nozzle swap system that Bambu Lab pioneered with the A1 and A1 Mini. Want to swap nozzles? Take off the silicone sock, unclip the old nozzle, clip in the new one, and put the sock back on. It literally just takes a couple of seconds, and you can do it with the nozzle cold. In fact, you should do it with a nozzle cold so you don't burn yourself. On the P1 series, there were screws and wire connectors involved, plus you'd have to move the ceramic heater and the thermistor over to the new nozzle if you weren't swapping in a pre-wired one, so this is a huge improvement. And last, of course, but not least, the tool head includes a filament runout sensor, so it can let you know when you need to run out and get more. Although the P2S doesn't have active chamber heating, it does inherit active airflow management for the build chamber from the H2 series. It can circulate the already warm air inside the chamber when cooling prints done with higher temperature materials that need to stay hotter. But it can also pull in outside air to keep the chamber cooler when printing lower temperature materials. That means you won't have to leave the printer's front door open when printing PLA. Now, I just want to add that I've never actually had to do that with my enclosed Bambu Lab printers. I've always printed PLA with the door closed and the top glass on, and never had a nozzle clog due to heat creep from the chamber getting too hot. But just because it never happened to me doesn't mean it didn't happen to other people, and Bambu Lab has taken steps to address it. On both the P1S and the P2S, the Y and Z axes ride on steel rods. But the P2S is using steel rods on the X-axis as well, where the P1 series used carbon fiber rods. Bambu Lab says they made this change because it's easier to maintain the steel rods, just wipe them down to clean them off. One more thing to note while we're still inside the print chamber. The live view camera is now a 30 frame per second full HD camera with a resolution of 1920 by 1080. This gives a much better image than the low frame rate 1280 by 720 camera in the P1 series. That improved camera, along with smarter electronics and software, allows the P2S to implement print failure detection by using AI to monitor the camera. So if a print gets loose from the build plate, or you start incubating a spaghetti monster, the printer can pause the print and ask your opinion about whether what it thinks is a problem is really a problem. Stepping outside the chamber, let's talk about the AMS2 Pro that comes with the P2S AMS combo. This is the same improved AMS unit that's been shipping with the H2S and H2D combos. So it's faster, more durable, and easier to work on if filament snaps inside one of the tubes. Oh, and it's also a filament dryer. As shipped, you can either dry filament or run a print job, but not both at the same time. But with an external power supply connected to an AMS2 Pro, you can print and dry at the same time. Like the P1S before it, which could use up to 4 AMS units, the P2S can use a maximum of 4 AMS2 Pro units for a total of 16 filament slots. But the P2S can, at the same time, also use up to 4 single-slot AMS-HT units for a grand total of 20 filament slots. Now, there are additional accessories needed to make that happen, power bricks and PTFE tubing and AMS hubs and the like, but the point is, it can be done if you've got a mighty need for such a thing. But enough about the specs and features, let's look at a few prints. Here are some of the things that I printed with the P2S. This is just the Bambu cube, a simple 27-minute test print to make sure the printer is working correctly. I printed it in some orange Bambu Lab PLA basic filament, and it turned out great with no issues that I can see. I mean, there's really not much to say about a test cube. It has the X and Y faces marked with indented letters, and there are two different styles of the Bambu Lab logo. Down through the middle of it, there's another rendition of the Bambu Lab logo in the form of unsupported bridges across the interior. So, good cube, no problems. On to the next. Here's Aria the Dragon by designer Loubie 3D. I used Bambu Studio to paint the model, so it's a three-color print. I used some red, white, and blue filament from a subscription box that Sliceworks recently sent to me, and I think the results are kind of interesting. I'm not a super great artist, and I don't always have a lot of patience, and Aria is such an intricate little dragon that she can be a challenge to paint, at least for me. So I did the base in red and white, and Aria herself in that same stark white, and I used the blue for her eyes. She took about 5.5 hours to print. As with all multicolor single nozzle printers, there's purge waste. In this case, it's 84 grams of waste, including the priming tower for 19 grams of finished print. But I think she looks great. The color transitions are nice and sharp, and there's no stringing anywhere to be seen. I don't see anything to complain about on this print. This Fidget cube by LaForest Labs on printables printed in 1 hour and 36 minutes. I used Protopasta Nebula Silver Silk Multicolor HTPLA filament for this one. Man, that name is a mouthful. But it printed without any problems, and the surface finish is smooth and silky. The hinged segments move without any issues. Plus, the color transitions on that Protopasta filament are really pretty. If there's any problem with this print, it's that it's too fun to play with and too hard to put down. Next, I printed this Herringbone Planetary gear designed by Emmett Lalish, which took 1 hour and 13 minutes. This was printed in some Polymaker Polylite Silk Magenta PLA. This thing is shiny. It also spins really well. This is one of those things that can only be made by 3D printing. The gears use a herringbone pattern for the teeth so they stay aligned. If the parts were printed separately, you wouldn't be able to assemble it afterward. I don't see any major issues with this print, although the silk filament does sort of enhance the visibility of the Z seam here. But this worked right off the build plate, and like I said, it spins great. Okay, time to set that down and move on. This is the SKÅDIS Universal Cable Clip by Pixel. It's designed to snap into IKEA SKÅDIS pegboards. I got this new Cyber One workbench from LiveTab, and yes, word of warning, there's going to be a video about it soon. It has a SKÅDIS-style pegboard back, and this cable clip was exactly what I was looking for. This one has 10 cable slots, but Pixel has versions with fewer slots and even vertically oriented ones. It came out great in this green Polymaker PLA, and thanks to its flexible ribbon-like design, it can hold cables of different diameters without a problem. They just snap in and snap right back out. So the last thing I printed was one of the Bambu Lab wireless mouse kits. A few years ago, I printed the parts in a kind of a fire and ice theme, but this time I did it in black and green, mostly to match the aesthetic of the Cyber One. That's one of the fun things about this mouse kit. You can print a new set of parts in a few hours and get a completely different look. I think it came out really nice. Now, I'm usually more of a trackpad user, but having a mouse nearby is handy too. Okay, so now I want to go over what I like and don't like about the printer, starting with what I like. Unboxing and setup is still super quick. It's under about 20-ish minutes to get it out of the box, get the AMS unit out of the inside, get all the protective films off of everything, connect the AMS to the printer, and finally power it up. Bambu Lab added cutouts at the bottom of the left and right sides so you can get your fingers under it to pick it up or move it around. They started this with the H2 series, and I'm glad they did. Moving the older enclosed printers was usually an exercise in getting your fingers pinched under that edge, particularly when setting them back down. I also really like the super bright build chamber lighting and the improved camera. And I like that the print chamber is a lot easier to clean out now. After a while, you'll end up with little bits of filament sitting at the bottom of the printer. On the P1 and X1 series printers, the front edge was a 90 degree lip, so it was kind of a pain to have to reach in and pick out all those little filament bits. With the new P2S, that edge slopes up like a ramp, so you can just slide things right out. Super handy. And of course, the new screen is a nice touch. So that's some of the stuff I like. And what about the things I don't like on the P2S? Well, that's kind of a tough one. I mean, there's still the issue of purge waste. I've said before that it's an issue that affects any single nozzle multicolor printer, and that's true. But if you watched any videos at all about this kind of multicolor printing, purge waste isn't going to be a sudden shocker, so eh? Oh, here's one. The printer needs a USB flash drive to be plugged in if you're intending to do time-lapse videos or if you need to export logs to send in for troubleshooting. But it doesn't come with one. I'd like Bambu Lab to consider including one with the printer, but historically they've never included removable media with their printers, so that's not likely to happen. Still, it would be nice. What about improvements? Even though this is a refreshed and much improved P-Series printer, is there anything else I would have liked to have seen on it? Actually, yes. I think it would be cool if the front of the bed had an LED status bar like the H2 series does. That would make it super easy to see the printer's progress and status from across the room without having to pop open the Bambu Studio app on the computer or the Bambu Handy app on my phone. But apart from that, no, I think the P2S is actually a darn good printer as is. With all its upgrades, the P2S is much more like an X1 Carbon than the P1S ever was, even improving on it in some ways. And the price is expected to be about the same as the P1S. Preliminary information I've seen says the P2S on its own should still be $549 US, with the P2S AMS combo coming in at $799 US, which is about 50 bucks more than the P1S combo. Tariffs may play a role in the final pricing, but that's the information I've got for now. If you had been considering getting a P1S, the P2S is definitely going to make you smile. If you've been considering an X1 Carbon, the P2S gives you almost everything the X1C has, minus the micro LiDAR and the first layer scanning features, but it also won't cost you as much. So that's the new Bambu Lab P2S AMS combo. Thanks again to Bambu Lab for sending this over early so we could take a look at it. Thank you for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.